ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯕꯨ ꯈꯨꯔꯨꯝꯖꯔꯤ ꯏꯝꯄꯦꯛ ꯇꯤꯚꯤꯒꯤ ꯅ꯭ꯌꯨꯁ ꯑꯦꯅꯥꯂꯥꯏꯁꯤꯁꯀꯤ ꯊꯧꯔꯝ ꯑꯃ ꯑꯣꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯃꯅꯨꯡ ꯍꯨꯠꯅ ꯍꯥꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯊꯧꯔꯝ ꯑꯁꯤꯗ ꯉꯁꯤ ꯃꯤꯠꯌꯦꯡ ꯇꯥꯕꯤꯕ ꯄꯨꯝꯅꯃꯛꯄꯨ ꯑꯍꯥꯟꯕꯗ ꯇꯔꯥꯝꯅ ꯑꯣꯛꯆꯔꯤ ꯂꯣꯏꯅ ꯂꯣꯏꯅꯅ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯃꯅꯨꯡ ꯍꯨꯠꯅ ꯍꯥꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯊꯧꯔꯝ ꯑꯁꯤꯗ ꯌꯥꯎꯕꯤꯔꯤꯕ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯕꯨ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯃꯅꯨꯡ ꯍꯨꯠꯅ ꯍꯥꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯊꯧꯔꯝ ꯑꯁꯤꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯃꯅꯨꯡ ꯍꯨꯠꯅ ꯍꯥꯏꯔꯤꯕ ꯊꯧꯔꯝ ꯑꯁꯤꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯈꯟꯅ ꯅꯩꯅꯒꯗꯧꯔꯤꯕ ꯄꯣꯠ ꯑꯁꯤ ꯀꯔꯤꯅꯣ ꯍꯥꯏꯕꯁꯤ ꯂꯥꯏꯔꯤꯛ ꯑꯁꯤꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯈꯪꯕ ꯉꯝꯃꯤ ꯑꯗꯨꯅ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯕꯨ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯈꯨꯔꯨꯝꯖꯔꯤ ꯑꯗꯨꯅ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯕꯨ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯈꯨꯔꯨꯝꯖꯔꯤ ꯑꯗꯨꯅ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯕꯨ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯈꯨꯔꯨꯝꯖꯔꯤ Here and welcome to Manuhun also.
Thank
Secondly,
you.
I also welcome Madam Nidhi Mani Tripathi, Secretary Tourism Government of Manipur to Manuhuna. And lastly, Yamung Kogi Dr. R.K. Nimai, Vice Chairman, Imasi Foundation. First of all, Yamung the last Yamung Kogi Han, the Gehun Imasi Foundation, upon the personalities in the culture and the top of different fields, key power, Mayamaka. Manipur ka aur kaan mazhi interact topic ki tanzam ho to ka Manipur miyam de pin ba mayam su pang topic re hante ki sisu especially second world war ga mari leina badi o edu lari tel lekne to hante ki matang sna kari wakhlon da kari objective tan hante ki matang si ko ki kanat ka aur ga mas ki bond so wi wafum lai si
hante ki matang ge swain tok jab ne ko ki ma si foundation to se mkb ro de ni si ko ki Manipur ki culture ki form men te yam na contribution to giram am ne ado hojik su ko ki Manipur si pi ab se pik na ko ki lari te gi kari te gi e ba da ꯁꯤ ꯌꯥꯝꯅ ꯄꯨꯊꯣꯛꯄ ꯍꯥꯏꯗꯤ ꯌꯥꯝꯅ ꯀ꯭ꯔꯤꯌꯦꯇꯤꯕꯀꯤ ꯑꯦꯔꯤꯌꯥꯁꯤꯗ ꯁꯤꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯌꯥꯝꯅ ꯀꯟꯇ꯭ꯔꯤꯕ꯭ꯌꯨꯁꯟ ꯇꯧꯕ ꯁꯣꯁꯥꯏꯇꯤ ꯑꯃꯅꯤ ꯃꯅꯤꯄꯨꯔꯤꯁꯦ ꯑꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯍꯟꯗꯛꯀꯤ ꯕꯨꯛ ꯂꯣꯟꯁꯤ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯇꯨꯔꯤꯖꯝ ꯗꯤꯄꯥꯔꯠꯃꯦꯟꯒ ꯄꯨꯟꯅ ꯇꯧꯖꯔꯤꯕꯁꯤ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯇꯨꯔꯤꯖꯝꯁꯦ ꯇꯧꯅꯕ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯔꯘꯨꯒꯤ ꯂꯥꯏꯔꯤꯛꯁꯤ ꯔꯤꯂꯤꯁ ꯇꯧꯕ ꯃꯇꯝꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯏꯃꯥ ꯍꯣꯔꯟ ꯍꯥꯏꯅ ꯃꯗꯨꯒꯤ ꯇꯨꯔꯤꯁꯀꯤ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯇꯨꯔꯤꯖꯝꯒꯤ ꯇꯧꯕ ꯍꯥꯟꯅ ꯃꯤ ꯀꯌꯥ ꯑꯃ ꯊꯥꯈ꯭ꯔꯦ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯀꯣꯍꯤꯃꯥꯒꯤꯁꯤꯗ ꯑꯗ ꯃꯥꯁꯤ ꯌꯥꯎꯔꯀꯥꯟꯁꯤꯗ ꯍꯦꯟꯅ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯁꯦꯀꯦꯟ ꯋꯥꯔꯜ ꯋꯥꯔꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯏꯝꯐꯥꯜꯒꯤ ꯕꯦꯇꯜ ꯑꯁꯤꯒꯤ ꯏꯝꯄꯣꯔꯇꯦꯟꯁ ꯑꯁꯤ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯗ ꯍꯦꯟꯅ ꯍꯥꯟꯅꯁꯨ ꯃꯌꯥꯝꯅ ꯑꯗꯨꯝ ꯈꯪꯗ ꯂꯩꯕ ꯑꯗꯨꯗꯒꯤ ꯑꯃꯨꯛꯀ ꯍꯦꯟꯅ ꯈꯪꯍꯟꯕ ꯑꯗꯨꯒꯤ ꯃꯊꯛꯇꯁꯨ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯃꯅꯤꯄꯨꯔꯅ ꯀꯟꯇ꯭ꯔꯤꯕ꯭ꯌꯨꯠ ꯇꯧꯔꯤꯕ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯂꯤꯇꯔꯦꯆꯔꯒꯤ ꯏꯟ ꯗꯤꯐ꯭ꯔꯦꯟ ꯑꯦꯁꯄꯦꯛꯁ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯂꯤꯇꯔꯦꯆꯔꯗ ꯇꯧꯔꯤꯕꯁꯤ ꯁꯨꯝ ꯈꯪꯅꯅꯕ ꯍꯥꯏꯅ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯃꯁꯤꯗ ꯍꯣꯠꯅꯖꯕꯅꯤ ꯑꯗ ꯁꯤꯒꯤ ꯑꯥꯏꯗꯤꯌꯥꯁꯤꯗꯤ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯌꯥꯝꯅ ꯅꯍꯥꯋꯔꯤꯕ ꯑꯗꯨꯒ ꯐꯣꯡꯕꯗ ꯂꯥꯏꯔꯤꯛꯁꯤꯁꯨ ꯌꯥꯝ ꯊꯣꯏꯗꯣꯛ ꯍꯦꯟꯗꯣꯛꯅ ꯃꯃꯤꯡ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯖꯨꯂꯥꯏꯗꯒꯤ ꯐꯣꯡꯉꯛꯑꯒ ꯍꯧꯖꯤꯛꯐꯥꯎꯗ ꯌꯥꯝꯅ ꯁꯦꯒꯥꯀꯛꯅ ꯆꯠꯄ ꯍꯥꯏꯇꯥꯔꯦ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯅꯣꯔꯠ ꯏꯁꯀꯤ ꯑꯣꯏꯅ ꯂꯣꯟꯁ ꯇꯧꯒꯗꯕꯅꯤ ꯂꯥꯏꯔꯤꯛꯁꯦ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯇꯥꯡ ꯈꯨꯅꯤꯄꯥꯟ ꯑꯦꯝ ꯑꯦꯐ ꯗꯤ ꯁꯤ ꯒꯤ ꯑꯣꯗꯤꯇꯣꯔꯤꯌꯝꯁꯤꯗ ꯁꯤꯗꯩꯁꯤꯗ ꯃꯥꯒꯤ ꯋꯥꯈꯜꯂꯣꯟ ꯀꯔꯤꯒꯤꯅꯣ ꯑꯍꯥꯟꯅ ꯍꯥꯏꯕꯗꯨ ꯃꯌꯥꯝ ꯅꯩꯅ ꯍꯧꯕ ꯑꯗꯨꯒꯤ ꯃꯊꯛꯇ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯑꯇꯣꯞꯄꯒꯤ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯇꯨꯔ ꯑꯣꯄꯔꯦꯇꯔꯒ ꯀꯔꯤꯒ ꯍꯣꯔꯛꯑꯀꯥꯟꯗ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏ ꯃꯅꯤꯄꯨꯔꯁꯦ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯒꯤ ꯋꯥꯔꯒꯤ ꯇꯨꯔꯤꯁꯀꯤ ꯗꯦꯁꯇꯤꯅꯦꯁꯟ ꯑꯃ ꯇꯧꯕꯗ ꯑꯣꯏꯕ ꯌꯥꯏ ꯍꯥꯏꯕꯒꯤ ꯊꯥꯖꯕ ꯃꯗꯨꯃ ꯂꯩꯕꯗꯒꯤ ꯑꯩꯈꯣꯏꯅ ꯃꯁꯤꯒꯤ ꯈꯣꯡꯊꯥꯡꯁꯤ ꯆꯪꯁꯤꯟꯖꯕꯅꯤ
ꯌꯥꯝ ꯅꯨꯡꯉꯥꯏꯖꯩ ꯋꯦꯜꯀꯝ ꯇꯨ ꯃꯤꯁꯇꯔ ꯔꯘꯨ ꯀꯅꯠ ꯌꯨ ꯑꯥꯔ ꯑꯦ ꯚꯦꯔꯤ ꯋꯥꯠ ꯇꯨ ꯁꯦ ꯑꯦ ꯚꯦꯔꯤ ꯇꯦꯂꯦꯟꯇꯦꯗ ꯔꯥꯏꯇꯔ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯑꯦꯋꯥꯔꯗ ꯋꯤꯅꯤꯡ ꯖꯔꯅꯦꯂꯤꯁ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯑꯥꯎꯊꯔ ꯌꯣꯔ ꯔꯥꯏꯇꯤꯡ ꯁ꯭ꯇꯥꯏꯜ ꯏꯁ ꯀ꯭ꯋꯥꯏꯠ ꯗꯤꯐ꯭ꯔꯦꯟ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯌꯨ ꯍꯦꯞ ꯕꯤꯟ ꯑꯦꯄ꯭ꯔꯤꯁꯤꯌꯦꯇꯦꯗ ꯕꯥꯏ ꯂꯣꯠ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯔꯤꯗꯔꯁ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯌꯨ ꯍꯦꯞ ꯀ꯭ꯔꯤꯌꯦꯇꯦꯗ ꯑꯦ ꯂꯣꯠ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯔꯤꯄꯜꯁ ꯋꯤꯗꯤꯟ ꯏꯟꯗꯤꯌꯟ ꯂꯤꯇꯔꯔꯤ ꯁꯔꯀꯜ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯋꯤꯗꯤꯟ ꯗ ꯂꯥꯁ ꯐ꯭ꯌꯨ ꯃꯟꯁ ꯑꯣꯡꯂꯤ ꯌꯨ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯃꯤꯟ ꯕꯨꯛ ꯍꯦꯁ ꯀ꯭ꯔꯤꯌꯦꯇꯦꯗ ꯑꯦ ꯂꯣꯠ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯋꯦꯕꯁ ꯏꯟ ꯏꯟꯗꯤꯌꯥ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯏꯚꯟ ꯏꯟ ꯃꯅꯤꯄꯨꯔ ꯄꯤꯄꯜ ꯑꯥꯔ ꯀꯃꯤꯡ ꯇꯨ ꯅꯣ ꯑꯕꯥꯎꯠ ꯌꯨ ꯁꯣ ꯗꯤꯁ ꯇꯥꯏꯝ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯖꯁ ꯋꯨꯗ ꯂꯥꯏꯛ ꯇꯨ ꯅꯣ ꯋꯥꯠ ꯏꯁ ꯗ ꯏꯟꯁꯄꯤꯔꯦꯁꯟ ꯕꯤꯍꯥꯏꯟ ꯌꯨ ꯋꯥꯠ ꯃꯦꯛꯁ ꯌꯨ ꯇꯨ ꯔꯥꯏꯠ ꯗꯤꯁ ꯁ꯭ꯇꯣꯔꯤ
ꯋꯦꯜ ꯐꯣꯔ ꯃꯤ ꯗ ꯁ꯭ꯇꯣꯔꯤ ꯕꯤꯒꯤꯟꯁ ꯃꯥꯏ ꯄꯔꯁꯅꯦꯜ ꯏꯟꯇ꯭ꯔꯦꯁ ꯏꯟ ꯗ ꯁꯦꯀꯦꯟ ꯋꯥꯔꯜ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯕꯤꯒꯥꯟ ꯑꯕꯥꯎꯠ ꯊ꯭ꯔꯤ ꯌꯔꯁ ꯑꯒꯣ ꯋꯦꯟ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯕꯤꯒꯥꯟ ꯇꯨ ꯇ꯭ꯔꯦꯛ ꯁꯝꯃꯟ ꯍꯨ ꯏꯁ ꯏꯟ ꯃꯥꯏ ꯐꯦꯃꯤꯂꯤ ꯑ ꯃꯦꯟ ꯅꯦꯝ ꯕꯣꯕꯤ ꯍꯤ ꯋꯥꯁ ꯃꯥꯏ ꯒ꯭ꯔꯥꯟꯃꯥꯗꯔꯁ ꯕ꯭ꯔꯥꯗꯔ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯗꯤꯟꯠ ꯅꯣ ꯑꯦꯅꯤꯊꯤꯡ ꯑꯕꯥꯎꯠ ꯕꯣꯕꯤ ꯕꯠ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯅ꯭ꯌꯨ ꯗꯦꯠ ꯍꯤ ꯍꯦꯠ ꯐꯣꯠ ꯏꯟ ꯗ ꯁꯦꯀꯦꯟ ꯋꯥꯔꯜ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯏꯟ ꯗ ꯕ꯭ꯔꯤꯇꯤꯁ ꯏꯟꯗꯤꯌꯟ ꯑꯥꯔꯃꯤ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯗ ꯐꯔꯁ ꯊꯤꯡ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯐꯥꯎꯟ ꯑꯥꯎꯠ ꯑꯕꯥꯎꯠ ꯍꯤꯝ ꯋꯥꯁ ꯋꯦ ꯍꯤꯁ ꯒ꯭ꯔꯦꯕ ꯋꯥꯁ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯏꯠ ꯋꯥꯁ ꯏꯟ ꯏꯝꯐꯥꯜ ꯁꯣ ꯊ꯭ꯔꯤ ꯌꯔꯁ ꯑꯒꯣ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯀꯦꯝ ꯇꯨ ꯏꯝꯐꯥꯜ ꯐꯣꯔ ꯗ ꯐꯔꯁ ꯇꯥꯏꯝ ꯚꯤꯖꯤꯇꯦꯠ ꯍꯤꯁ ꯒ꯭ꯔꯦꯕ ꯏꯟ ꯗ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯁꯦꯃꯤꯇ꯭ꯔꯤ ꯑꯦꯟ ꯋꯦꯟ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯁ꯭ꯇꯨꯗ ꯗꯦꯔ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯔꯤꯌꯦꯂꯥꯏꯁ ꯗꯦꯠ ꯑꯥꯏ ꯋꯥꯁ ꯁꯤꯌꯤꯡ ꯁꯝꯊꯤꯡ ꯗꯦꯠ ꯏꯟ ꯇꯨ ꯗꯤꯐ꯭ꯔꯦꯟꯠ ꯋꯦꯁ ꯋꯤ ꯑꯥꯔ ꯑꯦꯋꯦꯌꯔ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯏꯟ ꯗ ꯍꯣꯜ ꯀꯟꯇ꯭ꯔꯤ ꯋꯤ ꯍꯦꯞ ꯇꯨ ꯕ꯭ꯂꯥꯏꯟ ꯁ꯭ꯄꯣꯠ ꯋꯥꯟ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯗꯦꯝ ꯏꯁ ꯗ ꯁꯦꯀꯦꯟ ꯋꯥꯔꯜ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯏꯟꯗꯤꯌꯥ ꯗꯖꯟ ꯔꯤꯃꯦꯝꯕꯔ ꯗ ꯁꯦꯀꯦꯟ ꯋꯥꯔꯜ ꯋꯥꯔ ꯕꯤꯀꯣꯁ ꯏꯠꯁ ꯏꯟꯀꯟꯚꯤꯅꯤꯌꯟꯠ ꯇꯨ ꯔꯤꯃꯦꯝꯕꯔ ꯍꯥꯎ ꯃꯦꯅꯤ ꯏꯟꯗꯤꯌꯟꯁ ꯋꯔ ꯐꯥꯏꯇꯤꯡ ꯐꯣꯔ ꯗ ꯕ꯭ꯔꯤꯇꯤꯁ ꯑꯦꯝꯄꯥꯌꯔ ꯏꯟ ꯗꯣꯁ ꯌꯔꯁ ꯋꯦꯟ ꯋꯤ ꯊꯤꯡꯛ ꯗꯦꯠ ꯑꯣꯜ ꯑꯣꯐ ꯏꯟꯗꯤꯌꯥ ꯋꯥꯁ ꯐꯥꯏꯇꯤꯡ against the British Empire in the freedom movement. So that's, it's disappeared in that way. And there's another blind spot, which is that most of the rest of India doesn't have enough of a connection with Manipur. And so people, so we lack the understanding of how important Manipur is to the story of the Second World War and how important the Second World War is to Manipur. Because in this, Manipur is the heart of the story of India's Second World War. The war changed many things for all of the rest of the country. It changed the economy, it transformed the Indian Army, and the army grew to 10 times its size. People from all different regions in the country joined the army for the first time during the Second World War because of this expansion, and they served in various parts of the war, and the Indian role was extremely, extremely important. But the war only became real, only directly arrived on Indian soil in the islands of Andaman and Nicobar, but then in the Naga Hills and in Manipur. And here, the effect of the war was not an effect on the economy. It was two of the greatest armies in the world clashing over the hills and the valleys of Manipur. And so on that trip, when I came the first time, I realized that if you walk through the villages of Manipur and you speak to the oldest people still living, their first memories are memories of the Second World War. So it runs very deep here. It's marked in the land of the Second World War is marked in the land of Manipur itself. And so this has been a very important place for me since I began writing about the Second World War.
You see, about 2.5 million Indian soldiers are involved in the war against the Japanese forces or the Axis forces.
Yeah.
And about 40,000 Indian National Army, led by Subhas Chandra Bose, they took part in the war.
Yeah.
That means literally Indians are fighting against the Indians.
Yes.
They've been using against the Indians against the Indians, against each other.
Yeah.
But the contribution of the Indian Army or the Indian soldiers in the Second World War has never been given any due respect and recognition by the British historian or by the so-called Western historian.
Yeah.
Has this fact been clearly reflected in your book?
Yes, it is. You know, the thing about writing about India's Second World War is you write very conscious of the fact that you're writing about something that should be huge in our national memory. It's a huge part of our military legacy, but is actually completely absent. It's just disappeared from our public consciousness. And the reasons, there are many reasons, but I think you said one of them very well, which is that during that climax of the Second World War in Asia, which took place here in Imphal and in Kohima and all parts of Manipur, Indians were fighting Indians. Some of them were the Indian National Army fighting on behalf of fighting under Bose. Others were the much larger regular Indian Army fighting for the British Empire. But it means that the Indian identity in the war is not a clean-cut, heroic, simple idea that we like to have with wars, which is, you know, patriotic and simplified. Instead, it's a very complicated, ambiguous, doubtful position because we were fighting a war on the behalf of two separate imperial powers. Even the INA was fighting under the Japanese. So overall, it seems that in the long run of history, it was easier to forget about Indians in the Second World War, despite the scale of their contribution. And it's almost incalculable how important that contribution was.
So your story is based on only 3%. Even if it could attract a lot of attention of the Indian people, and also the people of the world will know much more about the contribution of the Indian soldiers in the Second World War. With only 3%, your story is based on only 3%.
Yeah.
That is just, we can assume it as a tip of the iceberg of the Indian contribution in the Second World War. If things like this are coming more and more, will the international community better know the contribution of the Indian Army?
Well, it's the tip of the tip of the tip of the iceberg, and so on. It's three people from my family: Bobby, who I mentioned, who is my grandmother's brother, and also another granduncle and my grandfather. All three of them went and joined up in the army during the peak of the Second World War in 1942. And as I realized, they didn't come back. So they were forgotten by the family for a while, and it took a lot of research to recover their stories. And as it turned out, their stories were quite extraordinary. But I think that you can go to many different families. In fact, most families in some parts of the country, and find out what the young men and young women were doing in that generation, and they'll have equally extraordinary stories. And especially here in Manipur, as I said earlier, everyone, practically everyone of that generation experienced the war themselves and then experienced it in either terrifying or heroic ways. It's almost a universal experience here, belonging to the generation that is now, now leaving us, in fact. And so that's why I feel right now is such an important moment to write this book, hopefully for people to read this book, because the memories that that generation holds, the stories that they haven't yet told us, that we haven't yet recorded, because our memory of this episode is so bad, Right now is our last chance to get them from them.
Ma'am Nitesh, I would like to know from you. Actually, Manipur was the only territory within the Indian Union where the Second World War took place. It was in Manipur between the Allied and the Axis forces, between the Japanese forces and the English forces. They're also mostly drawn from the Indian soldiers community, and the guerrilla warfare was started for the first time since the Second World War from this jungle and the hilly terrain of Manipur. So, knowing this huge importance in the history of the Second World War, don't you think that a lot of these Indian soldiers killed in Manipur, including both Hindus and the Muslims, they have their cemetery in Minutonghata. But I think they are not aware of the fact that their forefathers are here, they died here, fighting for the cause of the nation. But why are they not aware of this fact and that they are not coming in large number? What is the government of Manipur planning to attract those near and dear ones to come in Manipur? Because a lot of these Japanese and these Englishmen and other are coming to Manipur regularly since the past few years.
Yes. That's what, we should thank Raghu for his contribution, because he's an author and he has expressed his sentiments, through this book. But, like he just now mentioned that, there are so many families who suffered during that war. No matter they fought from which side, somebody from Japanese side, somebody from Allied forces, but Japanese people are coming, even Australians visited us, Canadians visited us, Britishers come. But Indian families have so far been, not aware of what happened. And like he suggested, because of that historical legacy, that gap is there, we've forgotten their contributions. Many people talk about INA. But nobody talks about others, like he said, Indians fighting against each other. You suggested like that. So, this is our job to bring that to the world. And Raghu has done it in his own way. But as, Department of Tourism in Manipur, it's not only for foreigners, for our Indian brother in other states, like, these three guys, what has been talked about in that book, they were based in Calicut. And, they were like studying somewhere in Madras. And then they, came here, his family. So, there are many more such families, and not only from India. What I feel, this connects, this emotional connect which we have through this historical legacy, it connects us to Japan, it connects us to Britain, many other foreign countries also. So as a Department of Tourism, we want to utilize this opportunity to bring those people to Manipur. And not only that, you are aware that, in our effort to bring Manipur at the global tourism map, we've been doing so many other things. It's a rich, culturally rich, natural beauty, blessed with natural beauty. The state is so beautiful. So we are trying to do that. But this historical legacy of Second World War is another aspect of it which we want to bring to the world. And when I heard about this book, I grabbed this opportunity, and I take this opportunity to thank Raghu. At our invitation, he agreed to come and to have this Manipur launch of this book. And at the same time, I would also like to thank our Honorable Chief Minister. He immediately agreed to grace this occasion. So you can understand the importance we are giving to these kind of voices. He has voiced, those sentiments so far, those sentiments which not been expressed in this manner. And I say that, it's not only war, war brings, always sufferings. It's like, what we are trying through tourism, through increased economic activity through tourism, we want to bring love, peace, enjoyment, from a suffering, from a sad story, we should march ahead towards some kind of, love, peace, harmony.
Ma'am, so, don't you think that bringing these tourists to Manipur, especially those near India who have been killed in the Second World War, will bring more, understanding, more unity and understanding of the Manipur in the North East? Because so far the people of the North East has the feeling that the North East people have been alienated and they have been neglected by the central government for the last many couple of years, unless this Modi government has come up and has stressed the importance that without the development of the North East, India cannot develop. Thus, we can't keep aside. So don't you think that they're bringing them and they make them aware to come back to Manipur and talk and react and meet, will it bring a positive change?
Of course, you know, that connect, that is what I said, that is an emotional connect with every family which suffered. The people of Manipur suffer at large, like he said, everybody he met that of that generation knows about it, and you know, everyone mentions, you know, about the war, those who are still alive. But you know, all other families, like his family was based somewhere else in southern part of this country. So there's so many families in India also who have suffered, and that, you know, bringing them to this place to meet their forefathers, where to relive those, you know, moments, it's like an experience for them, and that will obviously strengthen our ties with, you know, every other family, and that we want to establish and exploit that emotional connect for bringing people together.
So world tourism is very much on the cards now, and madam, you see, a lot of these foreigners are coming for the last couple few of years,
yes,
especially from Japan, from England and other things. So Manipur has a huge potential of developing world tourism, and the total number of the soldiers fought in the Battle of Imphal is around 2 lakh people, and around 80,000 people are killed, 60,000 from the Allied forces, that is the British forces, and the 20,000 from the Japanese forces. So if they happen to come together per year, per annually, yes, 60,000 Japanese and the 20,000 English soldiers, if 2 lakh these families come to pay tribute to their families every year,
yes,
see what will be the the economy of Manipur,
yes,
because Manipur being a landlocked state. So we should take that opportunity. So what the government of Manipur is going to do, are you going to announce something special in connection with this on the World Tourism Day, 27th September?
Sir, we are celebrating this World Tourism Day on 27th September at Andro, and we are having 26-27 some kind of, you know, showcasing of music, art, culture of Manipur at Andro village. And on the 28th of this month, we are having this launch of this book. So basically what we are trying to tell the world through this World Tourism Day this year, that I said, you know, 3-4 strengths which we have, we want to showcase to the world. So through this festival, we are organizing it at Andro, and at the same time, we are also having Manipur launch of this book. So all 3-4 aspects and strengths of Manipur, we are trying to showcase to the world. And so that people, because from Andro, we are trying to showcase our village tourism. From there, we are trying to showcase, you know, Northeast, and Manipur is known for music. We are showcasing music from there. We are showcasing our cuisine, and, you know, and in a larger way, then we are also trying to speak about the Second World War. So it's a kind of package we have tried creating on the occasion of World Tourism Day to tell the whole world. So, you know, we are trying to strengthen our infrastructure. We are trying to exploit our youth, because, you know, the large potential which I notice in the younger generation, the professionals who are coming to, you know, Manipur with good education and good, and hospitality sector, you know, we are known for, you know, our hospitality. So there's nothing, you know, which will stop us from showcasing this. And our government is committed to this cause. You know, every time we are trying to strengthen our infrastructure to increase the footfall. And I'm sure with all these efforts, we are going to increase the footfall to Manipur in any case.
Thank you. Among them, Khazin is Manipur. See, tourism potential is from that. Go Yamu in housing, Imasi Foundation, especially like Suki cultural activities, ki Urgasu, in one way or another, interrelated with Akugi tourism development, Marina Vadina. Hantaki, see, Minister Yabo functions the Ko Imasi Foundation, Gi Makaitiki, Akugi tourism potential, the Bumam Singsi, Akugi medical tourism, war tourism, adventure tourism, at the Gato Pomayama tourism, Yam Sing Live, say, Akui Taxan Baby Tanzamadi. Lahu bagi tanzado, lahu bagi yang kami berkomitmen. Apa
lagi foundation jadi particular area am dah beri concentrate tapi nanti we are basically
multi.
We do multiple activities and we basically facilitate activities. Ada apa yang na wajib tahu jadi jadi apa yang idea putuk coba tadi kerajaan na follow tahu juga. Apabila tourism the importance piri sini, apabila ekonomi the multiplier effect si tourism industry sini kau dah wang ye. Apabila lupaam bahagutam the masih 10 times multiplied tau, dengan ekonomi the tourism sector the lupaam bahagutam apa ekonomi lupatara kanau. Atas si ini Haryana agi handi, anda gi port tilho lahir bukan dah lupa lag, ni gitu si lupa ni zakran ni, dengan multiplier effect si lagi tau. Adunna ekonomi da ekwaya degi karena bersi the multiplier the having the maximum multiplier effect is in the tourism industry. So if we develop tourism sector, then all other sector will also be developed, whether it's in agriculture, in hospitality, all other activities in, will be developed. Aduki idea da khoina masi changhen jabane. Da khoina say what Raghu has mentioned, that there is hardly any books written by Indian authors. I have, about 20 years back, I have read a book, The 14th Army, which was written by an Indian author. It's a very small book. It is, I would not call it even a book. It is like a booklet containing about 80, 90 pages. Other than that, we have not seen any writing on the Second World War, particularly on the Manipur theater, written by the Indian authors. It is basically by the British, whether it's at Imphal or the Battle of Sangshag or whatever it is basically written by the British from the British perspective. There is hardly any book, as I had mentioned earlier during the preliminary discussion also, there is we have not seen across any book written by the from the Japanese perspective. Even though in Imphal it was mentioned that the two generals, one in Tamu and one in the Somra, doesn't see eye to eye. One doesn't obey the command of the other, and all these are interpretation from the Allied perspective. But we have not seen really from the Japanese side. So similarly, even though majority of those who fought and who died are from India, we have not seen any good work done by Indian authors, from the historians also. So many of the documents may be classified as secret till now, but see the contribution of Raghu is that he has brought out the forgotten part that we have to remember. In Manipur also contributed to the Second World War. Major Khathing was dropped behind the enemy line. He was leading the V force, which was the forerunner for your VVF later on, which came again during after the 62 war. So dropping behind the enemy line, cutting off their line, so it was a very risky business. It is like you mentioned about the guerrilla warfare. So it is this V force who started. Then your Chindits were there. Basically V force was also designed after the Chindits. So then my uncle was also during the Second War, he was in the Second Assam. So we, as a person whose family was there during the Second World War, basically fighting for what is known as the Indian Empire, British Indian Empire, we also feel that, yes, it was totally forgotten. Except for Major Khathing, with the Assam Rifle participated in the event, I have seen no celebration or observation of any Indian who fought for the British side being held in Imphal. For Major Khathing, yes, for his birth and death anniversary, Assam Rifle participates in a big way. Almost all the work is done by them. Their family comes, and we also participate in his celebration. So, Second World War actually changed Manipur from a sleepy 19th century. It leaped into the 20th century. My father used to say that when they were in school, when the first plane came and landed in Koirangay, all the schools were closed to enable the students to watch an aircraft landing. So that was the change that has brought in. Your Imphal Kohima Road, which ultimately became the lifeline of Manipur, was developed during the Second World War. Earlier we were traveling through this Tongjim Maril, through the Silchar side. So it made tremendous changes. Almost the entire Imphal was vacated when the first bombing in 1942 May happened. People scattered throughout. Jail was broken, then the bazaar was looted and all. So the psyche of the Manipuris, because we were fighting with very old decrepit weapons earlier. Then machine gun came, the aeroplane came, bombing started. So from a sleepy 19th century village, we frog leap into the 20th century.
Drastically changed.
And that impact we are still feeling, because we are not able to adapt to the changed circumstances. We, the next generation, we were born after the Second World War. We are finding it difficult to change the circumstances. Even now we are finding it, our children are also finding it difficult to change the circumstances. So I think that we should say, like Nidhi had mentioned, understanding is basically interaction, not necessarily government-to-government contact, but people-to-people contact is very important. We have to talk, we have to discuss, we have to eat together. If I eat somebody's cuisine, then fine, then you understand it more. Because our heritage, our culture, how we grow up is confined to other respect aspects of our culture. If we understand each other, then more understanding will come. But I have, which Nidhi had mentioned about activities that is taken by the government, and one of the areas which they are trying and which I hope is going to give a very strong imprint is the stay home facilities. Say people coming, staying in Thanga, staying in Ukhrul, not necessarily in good hotels, but in with along with the families with bed and breakfast is given. These are how tourism industry progresses. You can't expect a 6-star or a 7-star hotel to come overnight. It's impossible. So only when people have started coming in large number, then these facilities will come. But we have to make the first small steps, and we have already started. There are stay-home facilities. First step has already started. We have got stay-home facilities in different aspects.
Just to keep the momentum. Okay. Yeah. Coming to that point, Raghu Karnatsa, I think you just wrote a history, a very important this one history book, Fastest Fill, an Indian story of the Second World War, based on only 3 person from a family. If you could make a big impact and create ripples within the literary circle of India and the rest of the world, why can't you make by writing a story, the Battle of Imphal or the Battle of Kohima Imphal, because you have all the proofs, you have all the relics and the artifacts, and you could have a good, I mean, support base also, because the Second World War campaign of Imphal Foundation team are really working hard over the last couple of years, and that they themselves took the pen and initiative to open one, this one, War Museum at Tera. Of course, this is not big, but if the government happens to provide some, I mean, facilities, this will be also developed to a certain, much more better. But are you planning to write on this as your second Benson?
Well, I should say that without giving away the story, the climax of this book, it goes to many different parts of the world. These guys fight in many areas and in different parts of India. But the climax of the book is in Kohima and then in Imphal. And that's part of the reason that Bobby ends up lying in a grave here in Imphal, almost not very far away. But, you know, I think when we're talking about the potential and the power of World War II tourism here in Manipur, a good example is me myself. I came here as a World War II tourist. I came here to see where I discovered my granduncle was buried here, I knew someone who had fought here. At that point, I didn't realize I was going to write a book. I just came to visit. But what I discovered here was not just the Second World War. I also discovered Manipur. I had never come to Manipur before, and I didn't know anything about it. You know, I was just one more clueless guy from Bangalore. Since then, I've come 3 times. I've been to every district in Manipur. I have visited many of the different battlefields thanks to the 70th anniversary commemorations which the state government organized last year, and the volunteers and the military enthusiasts who were leading tours to the battlefields of World War II, which are spectacular places. You know, World War II tourism is a very big industry in many parts of the world. But it's difficult because in most of those places, if you go to France or if you go to the Eastern Front in Russia, that terrain, the actual land has changed. It's turned into new modern cities. But the battlefields in Manipur, where World War II battles were fought, look almost identical to probably how they would have 70 years ago. They're out in the hills, they're in Shenam, they're out beyond Churchandpur, they're in the hills around Jaisami and Ukhrul and Shirui, and they're beautiful in their own right, but they're also perfectly preserved, giving you a historical sense of exactly what happened and how difficult and arduous that war was when it came to Manipur. So I'm a kind of test subject for the idea of World War II tourism.
So you are a test subject for the World War II in Manipur. But sir, if you happen to write more on this, the international community, especially the West, particularly the British community, will know that we are not in a position to distort and mislead the international community through our history only, so that let a time come, so that these people are coming from India, and there's no more time for us to reign like a colonial nation for the last many years in India like that. So yeah. Why don't we give an answer like that?
I think that this book already delivers that message to the people who have forgotten the Indian role in World War II, to the British, but also to ourselves, because no one has done a worse job of remembering India's World War II role than we have ourselves. But definitely there's the story of Manipur and Imphal and that experience in the World War II is so deep that you could mine it not for one book or two books, but for a whole library. Like I said, it's the story of a whole generation, not just a few people. In the rest of the country, it's largely the story of people who are involved in some way with either the army or the industries. Here, it's the story of almost everyone. And definitely, I do hope to be writing about it. Yeah.
Mm-hmm, thank you. Madam, as you know, Manipur being the gateway of the Asian Trans-Asian Highway and the Trans-Asian, this one, trade and commerce is also likely to boost in a very short period of time. So Manipur is going to be in a very important place. So Manipur is the right time to attract all this tourist potential, because it's still by only by this one, world tourism, we can earn a lot of money. So is the state government not making any, stringent plan and policy to attract a lot of foreigners,
yes,
or even domestic foreigners?
Yes, you rightly mentioned, you know, we are, you know, in the real sense, gateway to Southeast Asia. Mm-hmm. And our moray, you know, where, you know, when you see that we have immense potential at that border also. And it's not only one way, but it can be two way. And the tourists from Southeast Asian countries can visit us. You know, so far as we have already showcased our medical tourism and our wellness tourism to this part of the world, and they have already started visiting us. But in future also, if you you must be aware that, you know, the Asian highway is being extended, and this a bus from Imphal to Mandalay to Thailand, you know, Bangkok. We are having a kind of, you know, bus service very soon going to begin. As you mentioned, that our present government is trying to connect this part of the world to Southeast Asia in a big way, and they are also focusing on Northeast in a big way, the present central government. So same thing, you know, this bus is also going to begin very soon, and that will also boost a lot of exchanges. And as sir just mentioned about that people-to-people contact, you know, the people-to-people contact to the Southeast Asian countries would going to really, really boost our economy. And as he's saying that we are taking one small step towards that, you know, big steps, you know, they take time, you know, it takes time. But, you know, we are moving towards that. And in that process, you know, central government has also given us a lot of, you know, schemes. In fact, we have developed one more circuit under Swadesh Darshan scheme, which Government of India has recently launched, in which we have also included Moray as a circuit. On way to Moray, we are also developing Khomjom War Memorial, which is a very, very, you know, important site for the people of Manipur, and also for the history which we had, you know, with Britishers, and the patriotic spirit of Manipur is showcased over there. So that place is also being developed in a big way, and we hope that on the 23rd of April next year, we will, you know, launch this place in a big manner, and a lot of construction work is going on over there with the help of central government, and state government is also spending a lot of money over there. So, you know, this circuit from Imphal to Moray we are trying to develop, and in the middle of it also we are trying to develop tourist spots so that we can stop those tourists on the way. You know, he can stop at Khomjom, you know, we are going to develop some ecotourism huts over there. He can spend night and then he can proceed towards Moray and that side. And same thing, you know, the people coming from Southeast Asian side also, they can come to Imphal while spending time at various destinations. So we are in the process of developing so many destinations.
The government of Manipur is making all possible effort to develop tourism. Yes. Reading and discussion, especially young writers, especially young talented Karnataka,
Manipur dasu idam nati e da even second world war ge like anihum matum thwe ge khetri bir ge ga sudum lai bane abo say there are a few authors in Manipur who wrote about a second world war
yam second world war ge wafum dana taba ko na how en ga yam enthusiastic ko en ga yam na talented ko en ga ida pagi masi ge sapu se
no see Manipur as I mentioned in the first part see if you look into the creative field the number of books that is coming out published every year in Manipur if you look into the size of the population and if you look into the number of creative works that has been published every year, I think we are the top in the not only in the country, I think it may be in the world also.
Unbelievable.
So in thousands of creative works are being produced. The only thing which we are lacking is the audience is very limited. We have got very few readers. So if you print about 1,000 copies, it is difficult to sell. So now the work of translation is going on. Some of our works have been translated. Say Imasi's two works have been translated, one the fiction and another non-fiction. So similarly, Zahira has been translated in English by the Sanghinath Academy. So similarly, good works written in Manipuri, if it is translated into English or other major Indian languages, then people will suddenly realize that, okay, there is a place called Manipur where the quantum of creative work is, as compared to its physical size, is tremendous. So this is where we have to go into it, because now Sanghinath Academy, the Sahitya Academy have understood. So they are helping us in translating the work. And mind you, translation is not easy because the number of good translators is very limited. And translation is a totally different activity as compared to creative writing. So not only you have to convey the meaning of the thinking of the author, but you are translating from one culture to another culture. So it becomes very difficult. See, in Manipuri, you say Nungani ki marakta ha. If you say that the yam between two stones has no meaning, but if you say devil between the devil and the deep sea, or between Sila and Charybdis, then a European reader will be able to appreciate. So you have to know the psyche and the culture of the language on which your work, the work is being translated, as also the work or the language in which the original work is written. So we have got very limited number of good translators, but Ibom Chah have translated Dr. Kalam's work in Manipuri. Mm-hmm. So similarly, Tanjim Vijoy and others are translating Manipuri work in English. And I think this will create an environment where our creative writers of Manipur will be further enthused to bring out better works.
Yapung aja jamun su koi Manipur da aiba warpanate khogi translation gi posak sidi akhoi translate to gudriba topa akhoi gi jati du gi mai culture tradition sing juta singna khangba matau ta aduna khogi khogi masing yamna thok to ba ne da number of good readers ma amsi yamakteri masi yamaga de hena su sakotpa porkani adu Manipur da awar patelen ke awar pati leite aduga khogi gi tang kuni panda pangtho kodriba khogi Karnataka book releasing na tra ma gi book se launching gi thromis da khogi lakodriba akhogi gi khogi sida sahita gi lamdal laiba aiba singi thamoi chu amoen phaba saphu thauna ling jendu pirgani habi gi thajabu du thamjari lone lone na matang sa lo sin bu gi tanja lo jabu lone na. I once again thank Mr. Karnat and Madam Nidhi and Dr. R.K. Nimai for a fruitful discussion over here in our panel discussion manukona 360 degree analysis of news and event.
Ai lo isalak pada akhoi gi raghu gi la release Manipur release da wesi da sida Manipur gi praja me am lingiro MFDC gi auditorium sida lyrics gi khane ne da yobi yo hai da na ani Imasi foundation gi mohot chilaga ai mane akhoi gi impact tv gi manu khone yengi ba mayam pura mak dai na akhoi barton da tokjari mayam khane ba da yobi yo hai jari. Thank you very much.
Yamung na appeal to wofun sigalune lulina akhoi gi losin bi tanjalo bagalina mi yeng tabi punum tagi kaina bi athini sigi.